Well, we're back outside, and Consumer Reports has just put out their annual magazine issue of their best cars. They rated sedans, minivans, SUVs, luxury vehicles, and you may be surprised at some of their favorites. Lindsay Paulo has the results.
Every vehicle that Consumer Reports rates goes through 50 different tests and is driven thousands of miles. Then Consumer Reports' annual auto issue names the best of the best. For the first time in 3 years, an American vehicle has made the list. The Chevrolet Silverado for top pickup.
It has a very comfortable ride, it's very quiet, it has great towing capacity. Overall, it's just a really good truck.
To become a Consumer Reports top pick, a vehicle must have at least average reliability, and it also has to meet Consumer Reports' new, tougher safety standards.
If they've been crash tested, they need to have done well. And this year, for the first time, we're requiring that these vehicles must have stability control.
The fact that the Hyundai Elantra SE comes standard with electronic stability control helped it earn top pick in the small car category. And another Hyundai, the Santa Fe, is top pick in the very competitive mid-sized SUV category. Consumer Reports says Hyundai has made huge strides.
Hyundai some years ago produced particularly poor cars. They didn't test well and their reliability was also below average. Their cars now test near or at the top of the categories.
It turns out the Elantra and the Santa Fe are the first Korean cars ever named a Consumer Reports top pick. As for the popular family sedan category, the redesigned Honda Accord is the top pick for the sixth year in a row. Lindsay Paulo, KCRA 3 reports.
We have some of those cars out here on our front patio this morning. Mike Quincy from Consumer Reports joined us, and we start with the Toyota Prius, which I'm assuming is a vehicle that everybody loves these days because of gas mileage.
Sure. I mean, with a recent report out with the average price of fuel going about $3.22. Mm-hmm. What we love about the Toyota Prius is it's 44 miles per gallon overall. And in the April issue of Consumer Reports, it is our top pick for the sixth consecutive year for a green car.
What does this car cost?
This is about $22,000 to $24,000. Great reliability, lots of standard safety equipment, available stability control, and honest 4 or 5 passenger seating.
Has some good features. There is leather inside of that, so that's pretty impressive. Now we're on to, this is a minivan.
This is a minivan, and this is our top pick for minivans. What we love about the Toyota Sienna, not only does it have this remote electric power sliding door, it has great versatile seating, pretty decent fuel economy at about 19 miles per gallon overall. Great refinement, very luxurious for a minivan, really one of the best family vehicles ever.
Mike, what do you say to the family, though, that thinks that the minivan is not as cool as the SUV?
Well, I'd have to say that that person should try putting child safety seats in the back of a small car or a third row of an SUV. And again, the minivan is comfortable. It gets, like I said, good fuel economy, available all-wheel drive for those of you that want to take it out into the mountains. Good car.
All right. Okay, so now we're on, is this a, would you consider this a mid-size SUV here?
This is our top pick for a mid-size SUV, the Hyundai Santa Fe. Hyundai as a company has come a long, long way. What we like about the Santa Fe has available third row seating, a really nice interior fit and finish, good fuel economy, about 18 miles per gallon overall, good reliability, standard stability control. This is not the Hyundai that you think of when they debuted in the late 1980s.
Is this what they're battling, just like the minivan, is sometimes our stereotypes?
I think so. I mean, in some ways, minivans, again, make a better family vehicle because they usually get better braking, better fuel economy, better handling and Consumer Reports tests. But if you need an SUV to go off-road or deal with the snow in the Sierra Nevadas, then this one is a great choice.
Well, ballpark me there, because this thing looks loaded.
Yeah, this is a loaded one. This one tops out about $33,000, but you can get cheaper ones for about $24,000.
Okay. And then finally, this is the new Infiniti G35, which is the S-Series, I guess.
Yeah, the G35 is our top pick for a luxury sports sedan. And the April issue Consumer Reports, we talk about how this car is a great combination of luxury, sportiness, excellent fit and finish, a lot of fun to drive. It's not a difficult idea for me, certainly, to get in this car every day to drive to work. And it really does so many things well, and even decent fuel economy, about 19 miles per gallon overall.
What are these things right here?
Those are the shifters. So you can manually shift the automatic transmission if you feel like running through the engine and running through the gears. You don't have to deal with a manual in traffic. I know how traffic gets in California.
Final question, what do you drive to work each day?
I get to drive all the test cars, so I'm in a different car every day, which is really fun.
That's pretty cool. We appreciate you joining us, so we appreciate it.
Thanks for having us on.
All right, so that's a look at Consumer Reports' best picks for vehicles in 2008. We'll be right back after the break.